New York, I believe it is, right?
Chicago.
Chicago? Okay.
Well, what he said.
I trust you. But would y'all please put your hands together and give a warm Denton welcome to the Nashville Bluegrass Band with special guests Jerry Douglas and Peter Rowan.
Thank you. 1, 2, 3.
For to carry me.
Train set. Thank you.
Come here, my little son, and let me hold you up. I want you to remember when you are grown how your mama and your dad were so proud and so sad watching the train carrying Jimmy Rogers home. I can hear that whistle blow, that old train is rolling slow. Sounds like it's crying for the singing pavement too. Back to the sunny south and go, and it'll never roll no more. Here comes the train carrying Jimmy Rogers home. There goes the train carrying Jimmy Rogers home.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Welcome here to the Late Show. We're going to do some tunes here that we haven't done in a while. This is one called the Kansas City Railroad Blues.
By request many times today.
Multi-request.
And I had the thought that it'd be good to send this banjo tune out to the late Carol Best, as many of you know, was a great banjo player in these parts of the country. Thank you.
Kansas City Railroad Blues.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jerry Douglas.
Supposed to be here this weekend, and he couldn't make it, so we're going to do a Bill Monroe song.
That was one of them there, I thought.
Well, it was, but
Didn't sound like one.
This is even more so. This is one called The Toy Heart, and Roland's going to sing it for yous.
You played with my poor heart like a toy. Thought of the name we had apart. It never came to mend you. The hopes romance you. Darling, you toy with a toy heart. Darling, you toy with a toy heart. I think you played a game up from the start. This toy heart is broken when part of word is spoken. Darling, you toy with a toy heart. Darling, you toy with a toy heart. Darling, you toy with a toy heart. I think you played the game out from the start. This toy heart is broken when part of words is spoken. Darling, you toy with a toy heart.
I said earlier that we had finished an album, another album for Sugar Hill, which should be released in September. And this next song is from that album. And it seems to be, it's not quite midnight, but we'll stretch it and do it anyway. It's a song of, it's actually about relationships, isn't it?
One in particular.
Yeah, well, this is about relationships, so I know you all can relate. This is called The Blackbirds and the Crows. Yeah.
Evo was a fast thing, most everybody knew. While other girls were running wild, Eva flew. Her life was the fast lane, but it soon began to show. So I begged her with me to go to a little home here in Idaho, and the blackbirds and the crows. One year we were happy and tried to keep our lives on track. While I was looking to the future, Eva was looking back. She said she missed the old life, and she was truthful, I suppose. The truth was she could never leave. The truth was the nights I'd grieve if I had to let her go. Blackbird sat on the fence line, crows flew through the sky. I whispered low into Eva's ear, Eva, you're gonna die. She's a half of my life, a quarter across beneath those wheat field rows. And no one knows who put her there but the blackbirds and the crows. Folks come by, we sit around, and I tell them how she's gone. I tell them how she packed her bags and wrecked our happy home. Oh, I tell them she's down in Atlanta doing cocaine, and God only knows. But Eva's not gone, she's here with me, right here where she'll always be, when the blackbirds and the crows. Blackbirds sat on the fence line, crows flew through the sky. I whispered low into Eva's ear, Eva, you're gonna die. She's a half a mile out, a quarter across beneath those wheat field rows. And no one knows who put her there but the blackbirds and the crows.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Peter Rowan.
We'll take a little time here and set up a microscope here. We appreciate all of you who've been so great audience to us this weekend. This day,
hey, hey, hey. Well, I think this is the best bluegrass festival for the money I've ever seen in my life. That is to say, so much great music here. Wonderful for to be in the audience and to be on stage. I like it. Yeah. Whoa, there it is.
Out bite.
We'll dedicate this to Doyle and everybody here at the festival. Get your sister, get your brother, ain't a Lucy gonna show Uncle John how to do the do-za-do while the kids and cousins chasing chicken out of the old back lawn. Y'all coming with another just to go a little further if this old bus don't break down. Campfire's burning in the night, my heart is yearning for the sight of the whole campground. And that high lonesome sound when that evening sun goes down. Hey, girls are looking mighty pretty too. Now look at old grandpappy, he's feeling kind of snappy. Seems like he just don't care. He's over 93, he's as spry as you or me. He just dances to the music in the air. It's that high, lonesome sound. When that evening sun goes down, I'm gonna dance right off the ground. When I hear a fiddle play that high, lonesome sound. And the banjo's right in tune, and the bow fiddle slapping leather. I'm howling at the moon. Hey, Mr. Fiddleman, play us on a little jam. Him to play riding on the back of a mule. It's that high, lonesome sound. When that evening sun goes down, I'm gonna dance right off the ground. When I hear a fiddle play that high, lonesome sound. When I hear a fiddle play that high, lonesome sound. Well, this is a special treat to get together with old friends here of the National Bluegrass Band. And I want to dedicate this to the people who were the original settlers ages and ages ago here in North Carolina and in America. Thank you. saw you on that path in Oklahoma. No one remembers anymore. In the great Smoky Mountain of North Carolina, that's where I have rambled for many long years. In the great Smoky Mountain of North Carolina, I follow the trail of was a-howling at the moon. She's a-howling at the moon. She went down to the honky-tonk. She had two things on her mind. She went down to the honky-tonk. She had two things on her mind. One was the man she left at home. The other one was the one she hoped to find. Oh, the one she hoped to find. But she's a howling at the moon.
Oh.
Jesus made the wine, he made the wine from the water. Jesus made the water into wine. Yes, Jesus made the wine, he made the wine from the water. Jesus made the water into wine. And the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there. Both Jesus was calling his disciples to the marriage. When they wanted wine, his mother said, son, they have no wine. Well, Jesus said unto his mother, woman, what have I to do with this? My hour is not yet come. His mother said unto the servants, whatever they say to you, do it. And they set before him six water pots of stone. They set before him six water pots of stone. And Jesus said unto the servants, fill up them water pots with water. They fill them right up to the brim. And he said, draw out now and bear it unto the governor of the feast. Oh, they bear it unto him. Oh, Jesus made the wine, he made the wine from the water. Jesus made the water into wine. Yes, Jesus made the wine, he made the wine from the water. Jesus made the water into wine. When the governor of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine, he knew not from whence it came. But the servants who drew the water knew, and the governor of the feast, he called unto the bridegroom. He called unto the bridegroom. him and he said, every man at the beginning does set forth the very best of wine. Whoa. And when men are well drunk, they bring forth that which is worse. But thou hast kept the good wine until now. Yes, thou hast kept the good wine until now. And this beginning of miracles to Jesus in Cana of Galilee, that manifested forth his glory there. And his disciples, they all came to believe on him, because he changed the water into wine. Because he changed the water into wine. Oh, Jesus,
he made the wine.
He made the wine from the water. Jesus,
he made the water into wine.
Yes, Jesus,
he made the wine.
He made the wine from the water. Jesus,
he made the water into wine.
One more time. Yes, Jesus,
he made the wine.
He made the wine from the water.
Jesus, he made the water into wine.
Jesus,
he made the wine.
He made the wine from the water.
Jesus made the water into wine.
He made the water.
He made the wine.
He made the wine.
He made the wine from the water.
He made the water into wine.
He made the water.
He made the
wine.
He made the wine
from the water.
Jesus made the water into wine.
He made the water.
He made the wine.
He made the wine from the water.
Jesus made the water into wine.
He made the wine.
Thank you. Going to sing a song now that we recorded on an album called New Moon Rising way back when, and well, all these stuff we did, but some of it we didn't, and this one we did. This is it's called The One Way Fantasy Man, I believe.
I was strolling down the street today, trying to walk in a straight line. I saw these words and to me they did say, one way written there upon a sign. One way I'm free, one way I'm in trouble all the time. One way I'm losing you, one way only you'll be mine. Stopped into a dusty old bookstore. Every name I saw upon the shelf was the name of God, and they all said to me, one way I seek thee, one way myself. One way I'm free, one way I'm in trouble all the time. One way I'm losing you, one way all the time. Thank you.
set in B.
Thank you, folks. We want to finish up our show here all together with a number for the father of bluegrass music. He's the guy who put the blues in the grass. And put the grass in the blues. I want to do this one. It's it goes back a long time, and it's and we hope we're not going to have to say this very soon to the father of bluegrass music, but it's a great tune of his called Goodbye Old Pal.
Boys, it was sad. I knew down beneath that mound was the best pal I ever had. He would lay, oh, he would lay. My best pal, no green horse, now he's gone to rest. I live down beneath that mound in Texas, way out west, where the khakis blues over his grave and the coyotes cry. I know he sleeps in perfect peace beneath the Texas sky. Hoodle-ay, oh, hoodle-ay.
Douglas, Hannon Wright on guitar, Roland White, Gene LeBay, Stuart Duncan, Alan O'Brien.
The Nashville Bluegrass Band, Peter Orr, Jerry Douglas. How about that? They're coming back.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. We'll have to decide here something do as soon as we all get up here.
Big thanks to Doyle Lawson and Milton Harkey, too, for having us down here again. Wonderful. And thanks to all you. What a wonderful audience you've been the whole time.
Take a picture. Go ahead.
I think we've decided. Going to be another Bill Monroe song as soon as we write it.
Did you renew your license for this one?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, some of these songs you have to renew your license every 3 years or you can't do them anymore. Bluegrass license.
Hey, Pete, I don't know. Have you heard about Sally Gooden? It's in G now.
Last night I went to sleep in Detroit City.
Every time I hear your name,
Peter Rowan, Jerry Douglas.
I guess we're going to do an acapella to shut this down with, right? Keep going.
Thanks, you guys. The money's in Pat's guitar case there. You just split it. Thanks.
We're going to leave you with this little one right here. It's called To Be His Child.
Send this out to Doyle Lawson. I bet he knows this song. We learned this from the Duck Creek Quartet, which I know that... he's very familiar with, and if he's not here, well, we'll just put it out in the air for him.
Once I was lost, wandering in sin, my child is worth more than silver or gold. To be his child is worth more than this world can hold. And with him keeping my soul, no I am his child, and that's worth it all.
Good night, folks. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. The Nashville Bluegrass Band, Peter Rowan and Jerry Douglas. Thanks a lot, Denton. I don't know whether we can get another one or not. They're checking. All right. How about a bass solo?
Here comes one more, two more.
They're back.
Thank you.
Thank you. We had them put away. That's why it took us so long. We didn't think you'd want us back.
I think it's time to call on old Tommy Stu Bob. And old-timey Jerry Douglas. Tell them about Sally Gooden, Stu Bob.
We had a lot of requests for Sally Gooden, and we didn't get our permit this year for Sally Gooden in A, so we changed it to the key of G, which is where Bill Monroe plays it, incidentally. So we're just going to keep it there for a while until next year. Thanks. Did we lose Jerry?
Thank you all very much.
All right, thank you, folks, for sticking around. And be sure you carry all your stuff, your chairs and stuff, because, like I say, the fire department's going to pressure hose the area out tonight to clean it for tomorrow's show. And thanks again for being such a wonderful audience.